On this particular meditation, I want to share from a social media post of mine. I wrote, and the title of this particular meditation is Never Can Say Goodbye. No, I'm not trying to morph Michael Jackson or channel Michael Jackson by any stretch of the imagination. But I want to share something that's one of the biggest detractors that we have is when we can't say goodbye to certain people. I wrote, real faith is to start on your walk of faith with full knowledge that everyone that started on the walk of faith with you will not finish with you. However, you keep on walking anyway. Everyone isn't called to, nor will they attempt to walk into your tomorrow with you. Faith keeps right on walking, whether others walk with you or not. Faith will require that you walk in cadence with what God has spoken over your life, even when no one else seems to hear it. Will you believe God, or will you believe the crowd? Will you pass the faith test? When the rubber meets the road, will you follow God or will you run after folks? You have to be willing to see them leave and yet keep right on with your walk of faith. Never can say goodbye. Many times in life and in the faith, in this faith walk in the things of God, you're going to find people that don't. At different junctures, your faith move will make someone leave your side. There are times that your walk of faith, many times you'll have to walk it alone. In passage after passage after passage of scripture in the Holy Writ, God has called a man, God has called a woman, and you know they may have started out with others with them, but the story didn't finish like that. Real acts of faith many times will find faith move, walking by faith, living by faith, will find people separating themselves from you. And it's at these times that when we can't ascertain or denote or move on from the people that have separated themselves from us, that's when our faith becomes hindered. Your walk of faith will start with a whole bunch of folks, but many of them will not go the road less traveled. They won't keep walking with you. Few of your scriptures declare that few will find the road. There's a way that seemeth right unto man, and it leads to destruction. You know, and there's another way but few will find it. You got to keep on walking anyway. Keep on moving with what God told you to do, even when others don't see it. Everyone isn't called to, nor will they attempt to walk into your tomorrow. So you can't stop at these different junctures because people pull back from the crowd, you know, from your presence. It may be a friend that's been there, kith and kin. You've been through all the struggles, but at this particular faith juncture, you're deciding to move on, and they're stagnated. And many times you need to move on. Doesn't mean you don't love them. It doesn't mean that you detract from them. It doesn't mean that they're less than you. It's just your faith. You got to keep moving with your faith. In the 11th chapter of the book of Hebrews, often called the Hall of Faith, you got to think there's passages of scriptures that Abraham went looking for a city whose builder and maker was God. Moses, when he came to years, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. One of the gifts, one of the great spiritual gifts that you're going to have to develop, it may not be mentioned just primarily in scripture, is the gift of goodbye. You got to be able to, at different junctures, be able to do, not wishing them ill, not wishing that their plans would go awry or their life would be a mess. You can still pray for them, but you got to be able to separate. Jesus took a different take on a lot of these things. You know, he didn't kind of play the middle ground on this. In Matthew 10, verses 28 through 42, Jesus talking, and fear not them which kill the body, but not able to kill the soul, but rather fear him which is able to destroy body and soul in hell. Are not two sparrows sold for a farthing, and one of them shall not fall to the ground without your Father? Verse 30, but the very hairs of your head are numbered. That's always significant to me, because it would be one thing if he just said they were counted, but he said they're numbered. So, you know, I don't have much up here, but when the barber cuts my hair, he knows that that's hair 10,101, and that's hair 102 and 103, and he knows the difference between them. Now, that's a God. The old folks used to say, and the choir used to sing, that he cares for you. God cares for you. If he'll look over the fowls of the air, he's going to care about you. Verse 31, fear ye not, therefore, you are of more value than many sparrows. Verse 32, where the rubber meets the road. Whosoever, therefore, shall confess me before men, him will I confess also before my Father which is in heaven. But whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven. Look, folks, you got to know, you got to be able to say goodbye. Don't ever deny God or deny the presence of God to keep company, to keep the crew, to keep the crowd, to keep the clique, to keep, you know, you being one of the mainstays of this little circle, keep the circle. Look, you can't deny God. Don't deny God. Verse 34, Jesus kind of separates and he settles the score here. In verse 34, he gives us credence that, you know, every now and then you got to say goodbye. In verse 34, he said, think not that I have come to send peace on the earth. I came not to send peace, but a sword. Verse 35, for I am come to set a man at variance or against, or to set battlegrounds against his father, and the daughter against her mother, and the daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. And a man's foes shall be they of his own household. I heard someone say, man, with friends like I got, I don't have time for enemies. We got so many frenemies and family. Well, many family members. I'm not saying your family members may not love you, but your faith walk is they can't. Many times they can't follow your faith walk, and then you know their concern for you may turn them in a lot of different moods. But it says here in Scripture that a man's foes will be those of his own household. You got to love them, but you got to keep right on walking. Verse 37, he that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And he that loveth son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he that taketh not his cross and followeth after me is not worthy of me. He that findeth his life shall lose it, and he that loseth his life for my sake shall find it. Look, folks. You're going to have to develop the gift of goodbye. You can't always, everybody can't stay in your life. Everybody doesn't have a place. They may have had a hallowed place in your past. They may have had a good spot in your present, but there may be no place for them in your future. Faith demands many times that you'll walk out of some crowds, that you'll come out of some circles, that you'll walk away from some boxes that you've been in. You gotta be able. You can't, you know, if you're like the Michael Jackson song and you never can say goodbye, your destiny will be ill affected. Your purpose will be affected. And many things that God would have for you will be stalled in your life, because every now and then you gotta be able to say goodbye to some people. Move away. Keep moving on. Don't stop the show. You got to keep on moving. You know, and you know, the Bible says that the just shall live by faith. Now look at the people in Scripture that didn't keep moving when they were commanded to move. We're reminded in one passage of Scripture to remember Lot's wife. Lot's wife was called to keep her foot moving towards new ground, but she was caught up with what she was leaving behind. Scriptures declare, no man putting his hands to the plow and looking back is fit for the kingdom of God. Look, folks, you got to be able to say goodbye. You got to go on your faith walk, keep your faith walk up. You got to keep moving, keep earnestly moving after the things of God. Your heart has to, my heart panteth after God. Look, folks, you got to move after God. And many times that means that every now and then to a group of folks, a person, or a whole crew, you're going to have to develop the gift of saying goodbye. Biblical. Didn't just throw something at you. Got the word to back me. God bless you. This is my meditation. Please develop the gift of goodbye. It'll bless you real good. God bless you.